see. It's about checking the information. It says complete the conversations and check the information. Hi, Julio. Good morning. I see that Julio is here. I have idea, Karina, Marla. No, Julio left. I think he's got problems with the connection. He doesn't appear anymore. Okay, so let's start. Okay, number one, it says, hi, where to? I'm going to 830 Center Street. I'm sorry, did you say 813 Center Street? No, 830. That's on the corner of Center and Main on the left side of the street. So what do you have in letter A? Okay, number one, letter A. That would be one option. Another different idea that you have. Okay, do you have the same? Marla, Julio, Aide? It is the same. Perfect. Okay, exercise two. Could you tell me how to get to Atlantic Bank? What is your answer? Sorry, did you say I'm sorry? It's the Atlantic Bank. Yes, perfect. You are correct. Okay, the three of you. MB says, I think so. Go straight ahead for three blocks and turn left. The bank is on the right. And your answer is? Excuse me, did you say right? Yes, perfect. Okay, Aide is writing. Nothing. Well, let's continue with number three. Okay. Number three, we have the time at 7:15. And you say, you can ask a question, Karina, for example, at 7:15. What time? As a question. Ah, yes, I'm sorry, it's correct. I haven't seen it. Yes, you're correct. Excuse me, what time? Yes, you're correct. And let's see. It ends at 9:05. And you say? Yes, that's right. Now let's continue with the number four. Okay, person A. Can you give me directions to a pet store? Yes. Correct. You say a bookstore? Correct, Julio. Did you dice bookstore. Okay. And B says, oh, let me think. I think there is a pet store at Bay Street Mall. And you say, excuse me, where? Yes. Correct, Karina. Excuse me, it's how far. No, Julio. If you pay attention, that question, Julio, how far? It's about the distance, okay? And here, person B is not mentioning the distance. This person is mentioning the place at Bay Street Mall. So for places, remember, we use the question where. Okay, so how far? No, it's not correct because he's not mentioning the distance. So it's like, excuse me, where? Or I'm sorry, where? Where did you say? Uh-huh, just like that, Julia. Thank you. Now let's move to the second page. Okay. Exercise two, it's about echo questions. Write echo questions for the underlying expressions in each conversation. Number one is your example. The concert tickets cost $60 each. They cost how much? Okay, number two, this is for Karina. Okay, number two, there's a great bicycle path in the park. Yes, correct. Number three, this is for Marla, okay? The stadium is on State Street. Yes, correct. Number four, this is for Julio. The aquarium closes at 8:30 on Friday nights. It closes. Remember, only you need the letter S, okay, Julio? Because it's singular. It closes. It's correct. Number five, this is for Aide. Let's go to the museum. It's just a few blocks away. Well, it would be, excuse me, it's a few blocks from here. Or do you remember Julio wrote a question in the previous exercise? In that question, Julio was mentioning the distance. Like this, it's how far? Yes, because we are asking about the distance, okay, of the place. That. Okay, now let's continue with exercise three. It says complete the echo question in each conversation. Number one is an example. A new deli opened right across the street from us. I'm sorry, a new what open? Okay, number two. Tim spent almost $500 on theater tickets for his family. Excuse me, he spent... What do you have? Yes, correct. Number three, I really want to leave at 6 o'clock. Sorry, you want to leave at what time? Yes, perfect. Number four, Howard is going to the aquarium today. I'm sorry, he's going where? Yes. Okay, let's continue. The next page. Okay, so this is the lesson D. Okay. Okay, exploring the city. Number one, life down under. Exercise A, look at the picture and check the items you think the article talks about. Well, you were supposed to read this article at home. So can you tell me what are the topics that are mentioned in this article? An open mind. Mm-hmm. An amusement park. A drive-in movie theater. Okay, well, so this is the reading. Well, you read it at home. Now let's move to the letter C. It says, read the article on Cooverpedia again, then match the two parts of each sentence. So we have number one, the name Cooverpedia means letter D, white man in a hole. Number two, Tori Bryan found, we have F. B, a very big and valuable opal. Yes. So this is B. Okay. Three, Cooverpedia became a modern mining town when, what do you have? E, immigrants came to work in the mines. Okay, so this is E. Number four, at present, Cooverpedia is the world's main source. What do you have? High quality. Opals. Five, as a tourist place, Cooverpedia is famous for its underground homes. Okay, and the last one, the moon plane was A. Okay, so we have this. Okay, the set for many movies. Okay, now let's go with the next page. Okay, here it says, read this New Orleans walking tour, look at the map and fill in the missing words. So start at number one. This is the Garden District Bookshop. Okay, so we are here. We are here, number one. Okay, now go to number two. Take Britannia Street 4 blocks to Philip Street. And then turn. What do you have here? Turn right. Yes, you have to turn right on Philip Street. Take Philip Street 1. Block. Yes, 1 block. The Coliseum Street. And then block, Julio. Block? No, just block. The Coliseum Street, and then make a right, yes, on Coliseum Street. They are on the Right. Okay. Now let's continue with the second paragraph. Now go to number three. Go straight. Straight ahead. Yes, straight ahead. On Coliseum Street. And walk to the end of the block. Make. Yes, you can use make left or turn left also. On First Street, then go go down for one block. It's right there on the right. Yes, correct. Okay, let's skip this one. Let's move to the unit 6 progress chart. Remember that we finished the unit 6 the last Saturday, I mean the last time that we were here. So this is a review of what we saw in unit 6. Okay, so it says mark the boxes below to rate your progress. You're going to put a check if you remember, if you notice, or a question mark if you think that you need to study one more time. So let's begin with the grammar. Use is there and are there to ask about places in a town. Remember, is there? Singular. Are there? Plural. Like, for example, is there a mall around here? Right. Is there a mall around here? Are there any electronics stores near here? Okay, these are my examples. Is there a mall around here, or are there any electronic stores near here? Now, can you tell me two examples, please? Using is there and are there. Are there any what? Okay, Marla, no problem. Yes, that's correct, Marla. And another example with singular. Is there? Is there a stadium? Is there a supermarket near here? Yes, you're right. That one is correct, Julio. Only pay attention here. We have to use questions, okay? You are giving me an affirmative sentence. Your sentence is correct, Julio. Now, the same information that you have, Julio, change it into a question. Is there a museum? Yes, Aide, you are correct. Try to use your information, Julio, but as a question. Only change it. Is there a cinema near here? Correct, Julio. Yes. Okay, do you have questions about this part? No, okay, this was easy. Okay, the second one says use across from, behind, between, etc. to describe locations. I'm gonna choose one, okay? There's a gas station across from Plaza Universidad. Okay, there's a gas station across from Plaza Universidad. Yes, maybe you remember across from Plaza Universidad there is a big gas station. Okay, so I'm using across from. Now, give me one example, please. You can use across from, behind, between. Okay, Karina, let's see. Like this, Karina. Las Anglas is behind La Gran Plaza. There is a bus station across from my house. Yes, Marla. There is a bus station across from my house. Okay, Julio, Aide, need examples? My house is across from a church. Correct, Julio. Okay, let's wait for Aide. Aide is typing. Okay, only pay attention to the spelling. Hi there. Mall is with letter A. Okay, MALL. Okay, mall. Perfect. Okay, number three. It says make offers and requests with can and could. For example, something easy. Right. Can I help you? This is an offer. Okay. And this one, could you tell me how to get to the stadium? This is a request. Okay, now give me your examples, please. One and one offer and one request. Offer, remember, as the name says, you are offering your help to another person. You are giving your help to another person. Request, when you need that another person helps you. What can I do for you? Okay, Karina, what can I do for you? That is an offer. What can I do for you? Can you give me directions to the cinema? That is a request. What can I do for you? That's an offer. Sale dirección segura. Okay, Marla, it's loading. It's like that, Marla. Clothing stores. Okay. Let's see how to drive. How to drive Jorge's car? The Jorge's? No, Jorge's car. Huh? Can you give me direction? One more time. Aide. How do you spell mall? Aide. Yes. M-A-L-L. Remember, mall. Okay, guys. Now let's continue with vocabulary. Says, name at least 15 places in a city or town. Example, gas station. So tell me more places in a town. Park without C, okay? Police office, police station, hotel, yes. Aquarium, post office, supermarket, school, cinema. Is it town hall? Park, pub. Yes. Okay, well, now let's move to conversation strategies. Check information by repeating keywords and using checking expressions. Well, as here it says, we need to repeat certain words. For example, can you tell me how to get to the park? And you repeat, I'm sorry, did you say the park? Okay. Okay, what time does the movie start? Okay, it starts at 7:50, and you repeat, 7:50 or 7:15? Okay, so we are checking the expressions. And the second part says, ask echo questions to check information. Okay, one more time. Can you tell me where La Gran Plaza is? Okay, La Gran Plaza is on the corner of Costera Miguel Alemán and Wilfrido Massieu. Excuse me, it's where? Okay. So, another one. The English class starts at 8 a.m. I'm sorry, what time? Okay, so we're asking questions to check the information. Okay. Do you have questions, doubts about the letter? I mean about the conversation strategies. No, that's the easiest one. And writing, it says, write a guide giving directions. And this is like the exercise that we did in the vocabulary notebook, that you have a little map and you have to complete with places and give the directions, okay? Well, now let's continue. I see that Julio log out. I think he's got problems with the internet. Okay, so let's see. We're gonna do something here. Okay. I think that's it. Okay, let's play a round of the handman. Let's see if you guess my word. Okay, Marla says, hey, give me a second, Marla. It's gonna be one and one. Okay, so Marla says, hey. My A. Okay, let's see, Karina, Say a letter, please. No, I can't say anything. I can't tell you. Just say a letter. No. Marla just say, hey, and look, she guessed. P. Oh, I'm sorry. Okay, Julia. What is that, Julio? L U A U. No. Aide. S. Okay, Marla. Okay, Karina. M. No, you were close. Okay, Julia. E. Marla, you says H? No, Aide. Is that L or I? Aide. L. Another one. Okay, Marla. C. Now you're going to guess. Hi, it's nice. Yes, Marla, that one. I cannot try with these. Celebration. Why celebrations? Because celebration was the topic for the unit 4, okay? This is what you saw in unit 4. And well, you remember that today you have your exam. So we're going to review, okay, about celebrations. Do you remember the name of this celebration? This is Valentine's Day. Who says Valentine's Day? Capulcanera. Okay, what's the name of this celebration? Karina, you have the clue. Yes, this is New Year's. Okay, New Year's Day. Well, the second one is easy because it has the name. Okay, so this is about Christmas. Okay, we have Christmas. We have Halloween. Okay, this is another celebration. This one, well, it's a Mexican tradition. Yes, the Day of the Dead. It's a Mexican tradition. Yes, you are correct. Let's see if you guess this one. What is this one? Not exactly. Yes, this is a revolution's day. Yes. Yes, you are correct. This is revolution's day. This is in November. This is, yes. Yes, we have Valentine's Days. Valentine's Day. It's very simple. This is a birthday. Okay, this is a birthday. Correct. It's a birthday. Well, here I have some ideas to review the unit 4. Okay. Well, the first part says brainstorm names of different celebrations. So we already saw different celebrations like Valentine's Day, New Year's Day, I'm sorry, New Year's Eve, Christmas, Halloween, Day of the Dead. Do you know any other days? Yes, graduation day. Have a birthday, a wedding. Yes. Yes, a wedding anniversary also. Ah, St. Patrick's Day. Yes. Yes, May 5th is coming. Labor Day, Karina, Labor. Mother's Day, it's coming, Mother's Day too. Okay, now let's continue with the second question here. It says, when is your birthday? Well, if you pay attention, I have two different answers. I hope that you remember. This is in, this is on. For example, my birthday is in, okay, in July, it's on. Only change it, Karina. My birthday is on November 4th, in April. Remember, we're going to use the preposition in when you just mention the month, in April, in May, in March, in December, etc. On July 10. 10, remember, is without H, Marla. Okay, 10. We don't use the H, 10. And we're going to use the preposition on when you are mentioning the day and the month. That is the only difference. Okay. So in my case, my birthday is in March, or my birthday is on March 9th. Okay. So now let's continue with the other question. It says, when do people celebrate? So let's talk about, again, celebrations. Okay. When do people celebrate New Year's Eve? Okay, tell me, when do people celebrate New Year's Eve? In December, correct. Okay, when do people celebrate Mother's Day? Okay, inmate on. Only change the order, Karina. They celebrate Mother's Day on May 10th. Marla on. Marla and Aide, it's on, preposition on. On May 10th. On May 10th. One more time, we're going to use in when you mention only the month in May or on May 10th. And remember, we're talking about dates. It's on May 10th. Remember the numbers, ordinal numbers, on May 10th. Okay, when do people celebrate Independence Day here in Mexico? In September, yes. When do people celebrate Valentine's Day? In February, yes, you are correct. In February. On February 14th, yes. Okay, now let's continue with this question. What are you going to give your father for his next birthday? And here I want you to use object pronouns. Do you remember the object pronouns like me, you, him, her, us, them? So, what are you going to give your father for his next birthday? So, tell me your answer. Remember, we need to use the verb be. Okay, for example, Karina is, I'm going to buy a present for Kim. I'm. What? Okay, one more time. Remember, we're using what? We have the verb be, are. Are you going? No, remember, you have to use I'm. Okay, Marla, I'm going to go to galerías. I'm going to go to galerías with him. Yes, that's correct. I'm going to a restaurant with him. Mm-hmm. Okay, another question. What are you going to give your mother for Mother's Day? One more time, Marla, remember the first B. I'm going to give her a flower. Okay, like this, Marla. I'm going to give her a flower. I'm going to bake a cake for her. Yes, correct, Karina. Okay, I'm going to give her a dress. Like this idea, I'm going to give her a dress. Okay, what are your friends going, I'm sorry, are your friends going to give you anything for your birthday? How do you know, Karina? Jesus. Ay, Julio. Julio, the question is about you. Are your friends going to give you anything? That is stingy. For example, let's imagine. Yes, they are going to it's just an example. Yes, they're going to take me to the movie theater. Yes, they. Yes, they are going to give me a dog. Yes, they. Are you ready, Aide? Aide. Okay, let's continue with another question. What are you doing tomorrow night? I'm not going to do anything, Marla. Just complete. I'm not going to do anything. I'm going to sleep very late. Yes. I think everybody is sleeping late these days. I'm not going to do anything. Yes, correct, Marla. Tixla. Are you in Tixla, Karina? I'm going to do, no, I'm going to watch TV only, Watching, no, I'm going to watch TV. I'm going to watch TV, just like that. Yes. Okay. Are you doing anything special this weekend? I'm going to it. So that's special for you, Julio. I'm going to watch TV. Or Netflix, yes. I think it's better. Watch TV series on Netflix. Okay. After class, that's good. I have no idea about what I'm going to eat today. I don't know. Maybe just some coffee during the break, coffee and cookies. I'm going to sleep. I'm going to sleep my house or I'm going to sleep at home. Because you don't sleep a house. You're going to sleep at home. Yes, at home. Correct. What are you doing after class? Oh, well. Why didn't ask? Oh, that was a question. Well, let's continue with conversation strategies. Maybe you remember in the unit 4, the conversation strategy was using expressions like things like that. It's like that. And things. And. And everything, okay. And well, you're going to use these expressions in order to avoid giving a big list of something. If I have here 1, 2, 3, I have 4 examples. If you pay attention, I have some words in green. For example, number 1, Jenna loves to go to cultural events, concerts, and festivals, okay. I am giving a list. I am mentioning 3 activities: cultural events, concerts, and festivals. Remember, in order to avoid giving a big list, we can use an expression like things like that, and everything, and things. So we can do this. Jenna loves to cultural events and things. And that's it. Jenna loves to go to cultural events and things like that. Jenna loves to go to cultural events and things, or and everything. Yes? So with those expressions, we are avoiding giving a big list of things. Okay? So that was the conversation strategy in the unit 4. They were on top. And things. And things like that. We have 3. You can say and things like that, and things, and everything. Only, yes. For example, if you ask me about my favorite food, I can say, oh, my favorite food is Mexican food. I like to eat enchiladas, tostadas, tacos, quesadillas, blah, blah, blah. So instead of saying a big list of things that I like, I can say, my favorite food is the Mexican food. I like to eat tacos, tostadas, and things like that, okay? And I'm not saying a big list. I'm just using the expression and things like that, okay? So now let's continue with example number two. It's going to be a nice wedding. There is going to be a band, nice decorations, and special food. So now we're going to change, or we're going to substitute these words one more time. It's going to be a nice wedding. There is going to be a band and things. It's going to be a nice wedding. There is going to be a band and everything. It's going to be a nice wedding. There is going to be a band and things like that. Yes, so you have three options. Now let's continue with the question. Do you like celebrations, parties, and special events? Or one more time, we're going to change this, okay? Do you like celebrations and things? Do you like celebrations and things like that? Do you like celebrations and everything? Yes? So one more time, you are saying the same. And the last example, Anna's going to get lots of presents, cards, and flowers. Again, we're going to substitute. Anna's going to get lots of presents and things. Anna's going to get lots of presents and everything. Anna's going to get lots of presents and things like that. Okay? So, questions about this part, guys? No. Okay, correct. Yes. Also remember that here in this unit four, we started using going to talk about the future. I have here some examples. There are a lot, but I'm not gonna ask you all of them, just some. Let's see. Dun, 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 dun. Okay, this one. What time are you going to get up tomorrow morning? Okay, answer this question. What time are you going to get up tomorrow morning? Try to write a complete answer, okay? Tomorrow. Perfect, Karina. It's correct. Really, Julio, at 6 a.m.? Why at 6 a.m.? It's too early. But tomorrow it's Sunday. I'm going to get up at 11 a.m. tomorrow. Ay, Julio. Okay, let's see. Okay, this one. What are you going to watch on TV tonight? What are you going to watch on TV tonight? TV series. The other guys. Going to watch the reflection. Yeah. I never heard about it. Okay, this one. Are you going to see a movie next week? If you say yes, what movie? Are you going to see a movie next week? If you say yes, what movie? Okay, pay attention, you're using a plural noun, Karina. The cinemas are closed. Ladies are closed. Rent? I never heard about that movie. Okay, what are you going to do for fun next weekend? This one. What are you going to do for fun next weekend? I'm going to call my best friend, correct? Okay, next weekend. And the other guys, Marla, Julio, what are you going to do for fun next weekend? Really, are you going to the park? You are supposed to be at home, Julio. Ah, in your neighborhood. Ah, okay, Marla. I'm going to stay home. So in that case is I'm not going to do anything. Okay, the first part, Marla, is like this. I'm not going to do anything fun. I'm going to stay home. Okay, I'm not going to do anything fun. I'm going to stay home. Okay. So, well, this is what we saw in unit 4. we started using going to talk about the future. So now let's move with the unit 5. Let's see, unit 5 is here. Okay. Well, in unit 5, it was a review of the simple past. And in unit 5, we started using was born and were born. And we started using some prepositions for time. Okay, to talk about times, let me here. Okay, it's here. So here it says, I started my English course in, if you pay attention, here we have this preposition in, okay? We're going to use the preposition in to talk about places, when you mention months of the year, or when you mention years. For example, I started my English course in December, okay? Here I'm mentioning a month. I started my English course in December. Or you can mention a year. I started my English course in 2019, okay? For example, Karina. In October. Yes, in October at English. Yes, October at English Access. Okay, so remember, you can use in, you can mention the month, or you can mention the year. So I started my English course in December. I started my English course in 2019. Correct, Julia. It's in August. So the second one, well, we saw this. My birthday is in, well, here we're going to mention just the month. My birthday is in March. How about you? It's in July. Uh-huh. It's in November. Yes. It's in August. It's in April. Yes. Is in this month your birthday? I day? Which day? Is it going to be your birthday or was it? 21, so it's going to be next. Yes, I day. So this time you're going to celebrate at home, I day. Yes, because we can't go out. So how old are you going to be, Aide? 14, 15, 16? 15 years old, Aide? Aide, yes, she's the little one. So it's going to be next Tuesday. Ay, Julio, how old are you, Julio? Karina. And you, Karina, how old are you? 22. Yeah, you're still young. Okay, guys, so let's continue. Number three, I was born in. Here you can mention the year or you can mention the month. 2003, okay, in Acapulco, correct? Yes, remember, here you can use the month or you can use the year. In Acapulco, in 1997, in Acapulco. Okay, perfect. Now, here we have the preposition for, okay, for. So, this about time, like a specific time. So, I lived in Mexico City for, you can say an example, yes, for 3 years, for 2 months, yes, for 8 weeks. So we're talking about time. Then I have another example. The same is about time. I stayed in Veracruz for 1 week, for 2 weeks, for 2 months, for 1 year, for 8 years, for 2 days. Also correct. I studied English for, you can talk about hours. I studied English for 3 hours. I studied English for 2 hours, for 3 years, for 3 months, an example, okay? 4 hours a week, yes. Okay, and that's it. Well, now let's continue with the other one. My English class, I used stay in my house for 2 weekends. My house is my, M-I, my house for 2 weekends. Yes. Okay, my English class is from, so we have these prepositions, from and to. Okay, so let's talk about the time one more time. My English class is from 8 o'clock to 12 o'clock, from 8 a.m. to 12 p.m., yes. So we're mentioning the time when we start an activity and when we finish the activity. Okay, we start the activity and we finish the activity. Example here, we can also mention years. I went to middle school from, just an example, from 2000 to 2003, okay? From 2010 to 2013, You're talking about a period of time, 2013. Okay. Now here, let's mention again the time. In this case, let's talk about the hours. An example, Soriana is open from 2, I guess it's open from 8 a.m. to 9 p.m. or 10 p.m., something like that. From 7 to 8 p.m. Okay, so Soriana is open from 7 a.m. to 8 p.m. Okay, from 7 a.m. to 8 p.m. Okay, perfect. Okay, here these questions. We're going to complete these questions using was, where, or did. Okay, question one, where was your mother born? Okay, here is was. Question number two, where, space, you grew up? No. Did, yes, did. Pay attention to this part. Question number one, okay. Question number one, we have this word, born, okay? We have this word, born. Remember, we're going to use this word born with the verb be. In this case, we're talking about the past. So we have to use was born, were born. Here, my subject is your mother. That is singular. So we're going to use was. Where was your mother born? Question number two. If you pay attention, this, grow up, it's a verb. Every time you see a verb in a question, we're going to use did. So, where did you grow up? Okay. Pay attention to question three. Again, we have born, and my subject is your grandparents. So, what do we need here? Where? Yes, because grandparents is plural, okay? Where were your grandparents born? No, Marla, where? That one is plural. That one is plural. We have the letter S. Grandparents. That's plural. Where? Where were your grandparents born? Mm-hmm. Now let's continue with the next question. We have a verb. Do. What do we need? Did, correct? What did you do last night? Because I have a verb. And last question, one more time. I have an action, I have a verb, have. Pay attention, it's a verb, have. Did, yes. Did your mother have a job? Yes, in all of them. In all of them. So one more time, remember, when you see this word, born, we're going to use was or were. When you see verbs, grow up, do, have, take, study, swim, eat, etc., we're going to use did. Okay, we're talking about questions. We're going to use did, this part. Okay, another thing that we learned here was how to use these words, the terminals. Yes, it is for action, huh? When you have verbs. Did you study last night? What did you eat for dinner last night? What did you do yesterday? Did you watch a movie? Did you go out last weekend? Did you study last week? So we're asking about actions, about activities. That's why we're using did. And remember, we're going to use was or were with the word born. I was born, you were born, he was born, she was born, we were born, they were born. Always. Okay, let's continue with this last paragraph. We learned how to use this expressions, words, and determiners. As you can see, I have one here, some and some of. The ones with the preposition of, we're gonna use them to talk about, remember, specific information, yes? For example, number one, some or some of my friends take evening classes. Some of, yes. Some of, because this information is specific. I'm talking about my friends, only my friends, yes? Some of my friends take evening classes, so this is very specific. The second one, there are a lot or a lot of new students in our school, okay? If I say in our school, one more time, this is specific, yes? A lot of new students. Okay, most or most of high school students have to study a language. Okay, here it says high school students. This is general information. I'm not saying the name of the school. I'm not saying if I'm talking about high school students in Acapulco, high school students in Mexico City. We have no idea. So this is general information. Okay, so we're going to use must. Okay, most high school students have to study a language. Okay, then only a few or only a few of high school students study calculus. Yes, only a few. General information, one more time. I'm just saying high school students, but we don't know which ones, what school, what city. We don't know, so it's general information, okay? Bob has three brothers and sisters. All or all of them are going to college. Yes, all of them. This is specific because we are just talking about Bob's sisters and brothers. Only, this is specific. And the last one, no or none of students like exams. No. Perfect, Karina. No students. Okay, because we don't know which students, high school students, middle school students, elementary school students, college students. We are not specifying what. Karina. Well, if you study, the exams are going to be easy. I think this exam is going to be easy. It's not complicated. Okay. Questions about this, guys? Questions about this part, the unit 5? No questions. I this is no, 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 no. Okay, so let's move with the. Okay, this is for. Okay, the lesson, the unit 6. Okay, unit 6. Okay, the review. Okay, here I have a, first we have a paragraph here. Okay, we have this paragraph. Here, what you have to do is only choose the correct word in this paragraph. Okay, excuse me, is there an or is there any electronic store around here? Karina says, any. Another idea? Just Karina is answering. No one. Okay, let's see, Marla. Only the first part. Yes, the answer is an. Why an? Excellent. Yes. It's singular. Pay attention, Karina. Is there? And look, this is a two-word verb. A two-word. Well, this is a noun of two words. It's made of two words. Electronics store. So this is singular. It's only one store. Is there an electronics store? And we're using an because here we have a vowel, E. An electronics store around here. Yes. Okay, the second one. Let me think. There is one or there is some. Yes, for plural. Okay, the second line, there is one or there is some. One, yes, there is singular. One is singular, some is plural. Remember, there is one. Okay. Front Street. Line number three. Can I park there? I mean, is there or are there a parking lot? Yes, is there. Yes. Is there a parking lot? Yes, because this is singular. A parking lot is singular. Is there a parking lot? Line number four. Yeah, there is or there are. Is, yes, there is. It's right across the street or is right on the street? Okay, Marla says on, Karina says on. Okay, so let's see, Julio is correct, across the street. Pay attention to this preposition, from. It's right across the street from the store. It's right across the street from the store. So you're saying that is on the other side of the street, across from, so across the street from the store. Yes. The next one, thanks. Oh, by the way, are there or are there any? Yes, because it's plural. Payphones, plural, any. Okay, and the last one. Sure, there are one or there are some. Yes, Julio. Julio's ready for the exam. Yes, there are some. Remember, plural. There are, it's plural. There are some. At the gas station, it's on Front Street 2. Between Max or next to? Yes, next to. Yes, next to Max. Correct. Yes, that's what I'm seeing. Marla, try to read carefully. Yes, try to read carefully. Take your time, Marla. Don't hurry up. Okay, now let's continue with the second paragraph. Here I have some words in bold: block, corner, directions, make, right, straight, tell, and turn. So we're going to complete this short conversation with these words. Okay. For example, hey, excuse me, can you space me how to get to Bradford Hotel? Yes, you have to tell. Can you tell me how to get to Bradford Hotel? Be sure, go space ahead for 3 blocks. Straight. Perfect. Straight ahead for 3 blocks. Then no. When we finish, I'm gonna explain why. Try to read carefully. Then turn, yes. Turn right and go to the end of the another. Yes, block. Yes, to the end of the block. You can't miss it. Okay, the second part. Can you give me space to the zoo? Yes, Directions to the zoo. Okay. Sure, go 4 blocks. Then make a left. Mm-hmm. Turn left again at the. Yes, at the corner. And walk up a block. It's right there. Perfect. It's right there. Okay, here. Okay, in this part. Here we're going to use turn. If you pay attention, when we use this expression make, we need to use this little letter, A. Make a left, make a right, okay? And here on this part, we don't have a, it's only right. Then turn right or turn left. And here I have this little word, A. So make a left or make a right. Okay, just try to pay attention to these, to those things. Excellent, that was perfect. Okay, here we have the conversation strategy. Remember, checking expressions and things like that. For example, could you tell me how to get to the stadium? How do you complete? Only try to complete. Remember, you have to repeat. Yes, it's okay, Marla. To the stadium, did you say? Or I'm sorry, stadium, did you say? I like that. I'm sorry, stadium, did you say? Okay. Okay, the next one. The art museum is just 3 blocks away. Excuse me, it's, you can use questions, remember. The art museum is just 3 blocks away. Excuse me, it's, pay attention here, Karina. 3 blocks away. I'm not mentioning the place. I'm talking about the distance, okay? Yeah, but what is the question that we need, Karina? How far? It's how far? Okay. Number 3, is there a place to play golf around here? I'm sorry, a place to... To play soccer? Yes, or it's correct, a place to play soccer. Or you can repeat the information, a place to play golf. Something like that. Okay, and the last one. Are there any jewelry stores in the neighborhood? Sorry. What did you say? On the next part. Okay, thank you, Marla. Jewelry store or pet stores? Yes. Another one? Your restore is a place where you can get accessories like earrings, necklaces, bracelets, watches. For example, if you come downtown on Cinco de Mayo Avenue, there is a place where you can find different jewelry stores. Yes, that's right. Those are jewelry stores. Okay, questions? Guys? No? Nope, nope, nope. Okay, well, this is what we saw in these units, units 4, 5, and 6. So we have 15 minutes. We're gonna do the exam after the break. Okay, we're gonna do it after the break. So you can have enough time. Okay, well, let's see. Let's go to your student book. Okay, this is the page 63. Page 63 in your student book. Okay, page 63 in your student book. I think we're gonna do just some exercises. Okay, so we're going to do the exercise one. It says unscramble the questions, exercise one. You're going to write the questions in the correct order. Question number one is, what are you doing next weekend? Okay, so continue with questions 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Okay, write the questions in the correct order, please. Okay, tell me when you're ready, please. Ready or not yet? Marlas es ready. Well, Karina says no, Marla says yes. Okay, let's wait for Julio. Aide. Ready, okay. Just let me erase this. Okay. Well, let's begin. Okay, question number two. It's almost. Question number two. Going to go shopping after class. Yes, correct. Are you going to go shopping after class? Question number three. Marla, after is you need the pronoun. Yes, Karina is correct. Julio is correct. Is it going to rain tomorrow? Yes. Question number four. City? Yes, Karina. You are correct. Did you move here from another city? It's perfect. Question number five. Where did you go on vacation last year? Yes, correct. Where did you go on vacation last year? That is correct, Karina. Question number six. What's your favorite subject in school? Yes. What was your favorite subject in school? And question number seven. Are there a lot of fun places in your neighborhood? Yes. Are there a lot of fun places in your neighborhood? Correct. Yes, are there a lot of fun places? Perfect. So we have 9 minutes. Okay, so it's about the. Let me see. This one. Okay, just let's do this exercise. Exercise three is on the second page. Yes, it's almost on time. So this is gonna be easy for you. It says add 5 words to each category. Okay, for example, we have events you are going to celebrate this year. Think about celebrations. Okay, like Halloween, Valentine's Day, Mother's Day, Children's Day, Father's Day, etc. Events that you're going to celebrate this year. Important dates for you. Okay, what are the important dates for you? May 1st, my birthday. Maybe you can think about your best friend's birthday, or if someone in your family is going to get married this year, well, you can write down the date. Okay, important dates for you. Number three, places in town that you go often. Maybe the beach, the park, the shopping mall, etc. And subjects you are going to study. But if you are not studying anymore, well, try to remember your favorite subjects, okay? Just let's complete the chart, this chart, please. Okay, ready with this one? This one is easy. Marla says, yes. Okay, let's see, number one, this is for Marla. Events are going to celebrate this year. Okay, Marla, this is for you. Christmas. It's like this. Christmas, New Year. Yes. Valentine's Day. Okay, important days for you, Karina. November 3rd, my birthday. Yes, that's very important. It's Mother's Day, correct? New Year's Eve, yes. Excellent. Okay, and this one is for Julio. Places in town you go too often. Park. Costa and the beach. Only the beach, the park, and Costera. And Aide, subjects you are going to study Or maybe your favorite subjects at school? Math with H, history. Art is without H. It is art. And that's it. What is that, Julio? What do you mean, Julio? I think we are over here. Okay, let's do only this one, this a brief exercise, and then you can go to your break. What do you mean, Julia, that idea doesn't like to study or what? Okay, guys, so let's complete exercise four. Can you complete these questions? You're going to use the words in the box to complete the sentences. Yes, I know that idea. Okay, so let's do the exercise four, please. Okay, ready, guys, with exercise four? Yes, okay, number one. What's your city? I mean, your. Neighborhood, like, perfect. Two, are you going to any birthday parties? I mean, weddings this year, perfect. Three, can you give me directions to a bank around here? I mean, a cash machine. Yes, walk, no, cash machine. Number three, four, when did you learn to swim? I mean, when did you learn to walk? Yes. And number five, what was your worst? I mean, best subject in school. Okay, guys. Questions? Nope. Okay, well, let's do this. So it's time for you to go to your break. So after the break, we're going to start with the written exam, okay? I have 10:02. Okay, so see you at 10:25, okay? So see you around here at 10:25, please. So you can go and eat something or have something for breakfast, okay? 10:25, okay, guys? Okay, so see you later.